طيب شباب، أول حاجة الله يعطيكم العافية. أنا إن شاء الله هحاول أشرح لكم to explain for you the medical terminology. We know that we are living in the era of technology and the era of e-learning. For this, I'm trying to choose to explain for you the medical terminology. And for that, I use just to go to this lab to explain for you, which is really important for you. Okay? Now we are going to talk about the medical terminology. Why we are studying medical terminology? We are studying medical terminology because all the medical terms that used in the medical field, most of them, the origin of these them are Greek and Latin. So we have to know the meaning of them in English, and even for more benefits, we have to know the meaning of them in Arabic. In order to know the meaning of this medical term, we have to know the parts of the medical term. And also we have to know how to translate the medical term in English. So let me introduce for you the parts of the medical term, which is very important as the first step to understand the medical terminology. Medical terminology, we have here medical terminology, or medical term. We have to know the parts of the medical term. Let me introduce the parts of the medical term. The first one we have here, root, which is the basic of the medical term. We can add some words or some letters for root. We call it suffixes. Okay? And we can add some letters also before root. We call what? Prefixes. As I have told you in the beginning, that root is the most important part of the medical terminology. Let me just make it more easy for you. I'll give you an example from English language. Read. All of you know what's the meaning of read. Read means يقرأ. But if I add ing, okay, the meaning of this word will be changed to be reading. Okay, so I can just simplify that ing and simplify the suffixes. Or sometimes I can add re as an example of what prefix reread. So we can take this example to make it for the medical terminology. Medical terminology or medical term, they have those three parts. But the most important part is root. Sometimes we add suffixes at the end of this medical term, or sometimes we can add prefixes in the beginning of this medical term to make a new word by making a combination between these things. So I would like just to know that you have understood this. As I have told you, we have root, and we have suffixes, and we have what prefixes. I give you an example from English language, like read. We have ing as an example of suffixes, and we have re as an example of what prefixes. Let us move to another thing and take something from the medical terminology, okay, to understand this. Let me just erase this one. Okay, we have a new thing now. Let me tell you, we have an example. We have the word hematology. Okay? You will face this medical term, inshallah, while you are studying in the medical field, if you are from the College of Medicine or the College of Applied Medical Science or the College of Dentistry. We have the word hematology, and the teacher asks you, what does hematology mean? So if we want to know the meaning of hematology, we have to know in the beginning, as a first step, the parts of medical term. What are the parts? We have hemato, and we have logy, and we have o in the middle. Let me introduce the parts. Hemato is a root. Logy is a suffix. Okay? And we have o, it's called combination. Okay, most of you, they will ask, and they have a question in their own minds and their heads. How do you know those are root, and how do you know this is what a suffix? Okay, to solve this problem, I uploaded an Excel sheet or a Word document that includes all these things, and will show you which words are roots and which words are suffixes, okay? Just to make it, you know, easy for you, I upload it to your accounts in Blackboard. Okay, let me just complete these things. The first step, as I have told you, we have to specify the parts of the medical term. We have root, we have suffix, and we have combination O. In the beginning, I have like just to show you what is the function of O. The function of O. What is the function of O? Most of you, they'll ask you, what is the purpose of having O in the medical term? The purpose of this one, just let this me just introduce it for you as an easy equation for you. You know what's an equation as, you know, معادلة. O function to connect. To connect. One, R plus R. Two, R plus S. So what does this, you know, as you have your symbols, you have this one. R, it means root. So O, the function of O to connect between R and R, between root and root. And also the function of O to connect between R and suffix, which is applied here, as you can see. We have here root and we have here suffix. And the connection between them, the combination between them, who combine these two parts, O combine these two parts between root and suffix, okay? Just to understand this one. Okay, now let's go back to the translation, how to translate. As you can see, hematology, it's root and suffix. What does this root? Hemato means blood. Why suffix here, logy, it means the study of. The study of. Now we have the meaning of these two parts. Now how to translate? If we want to translate, we have to follow the main step that we call the golden rule of, you know, translating, you know, the medical term. We have to start from the end and go back to the beginning. How is that? We can say, starting from here, logy means the study of. The study of blood. The study of blood. Which means Dras al-Middam. As you can see, I think most of you graduated from the high school, and in the high school, I think you studied geology, which means geology, you know, علم الأرض. So all, you know, words ends with logy, it means the study of something, okay? So let me just revise it for you and make a review. We have the medical term, we have the parts, we have to supply the parts, root and suffix, and we have O. We've said and explained the function of O. The function of O, we have two functions for O. The first one is to connect and combine between root and root, and also to combine between root and suffix, which is applied here in this medical term. The second step, we have to know the meaning of each word, the meaning of this blood, and also the meaning of this, the study of. And also they will, you will ask, how do we know the meaning of this word? Also, it's uploaded in your account in the Blackboard and Word documents. The third step, how to translate. As I have told you, we have to start from the end, then go back to the beginning. As you can see, the study of the blood. Okay? Let me give you another example. We have to finish this one because we don't need it now. Okay, now, another example. We have the word enteritis. We have the word enteritis. This is another example and this is another case. How we translate, as we have said, we have three steps. The first step is to specify the parts. To specify the parts. Here we have a root. And here we have what? Suffix. I think most of you will ask, where is the O? Where is the O that we use it to connect between root and suffix? Here we have an exceptional case. Why we didn't use O to connect between root and suffix? I will say for you that another exception for this one, that if the suffix starts with one of vowel letters, we drop O. We drop what? O. So the suffix start here with I, which is one of the vowel letters. We know them A, O, U, E, and I. So I have to drop the O that connect and combine between root and suffix. Okay? So this is an exceptional case. Let's go back to the medical term that we have it here. The first step is to specify the root. The second step is to specify the suffix. Okay, another step is to know the meaning. The meaning of this one is small intestine. While ites, this means inflammation of. Inflammation of. Okay? So now we know the meaning of each part. Now how to connect with them? As I have told you, we have to start from the end to the beginning. Now, if we want to connect, we have to start from there. So we say it's inflammation of small intestine. Which the means of this one is التهاب اللي هو الأمعاء الدقيقة root enterite entero. This is a root. It's the meaning of this one is small intestine. It means, you know, inflammation of is a suffix. So we connect them comes what inflammation of small intestine, which is called what the التهاب اللي هو الأمعاء الدقيقة. Okay. So let's review it. As I have told you, we have root and we have suffix. We don't have here O that we have used to use it with the medical term to combine between root and root, root and suffix. And we've said it and explained